Hi, my dear friends. Today is the first class SAP S/4HANA. This is introduction class. You need to understand what is meant by SAP S/4HANA. Okay. First of all, you want to understand what is meant by SAP. SAP. What is the full form of SAP? SAP Transfer System Application Products for Data Process. I'm repeating once again, what is the full form of SAP? System Application Products for Data Process. Then what is meant by S4? What is meant by S4? S means suit, suit means what? Suit means application. What is meant by S? S in the sense suit. And what is meant by 4? 4 nothing but fourth generation. 4 nothing but fourth generation. Suit 4. Suit 4. Fourth generation application. S4 in the sense fourth generation application. S means suit. Like what is meant by HANA? What is meant by HANA? HANA nothing but database. HANA nothing but database. I'm repeating once again. SAP means SAP Transfer System Application Products for Data Process. And what is meant by S4? S4 nothing but S means suit. And 4 means fourth generation. Suit means application. Suit means application. It is a fourth generation application. And what is meant by HANA? HANA nothing but database. HANA nothing but database. You people believe or not, but up to 2010, SAP do not have own database. SAP tenants of other database. Example, SQL database. RQL database. Is there any other database? SAP as tenants of other databases. Like in up to 2010. In the 2010, SAP has implemented HANA database. It is a own database. SAP own database. Example, nothing but this is the system application products for data process. Suit 4, fourth generation application with the HANA database. It is a business suit. It is a business suit. Example, you people understand here. I will give you one best example. Excuse me. SAP business suit. Business suit. What is meant by SAP business suit? SAP business suit nothing but R/3. Everyone please concentrate here. SAP business suit nothing but R/3. In this SAP business suit, we have 3 layers. This is the old layers. Okay, before SAP S/4HANA, we are used R/3 SAP business suit. Like SAP business suit nothing but R/3. R means real-time data process. 3 means it's a 3-tier architecture. It's a 3 layers. What is that? Like that is called, you know, like a presentation layer. Presentation layer and application layer and database layer. Database layer. Okay, example, everyone please concentrate here. Database layer. In this database layer, up to 2010, at the time of R/3, the SAP has tenants of other databases. Example, SQL database. Example, SQL database. This is one structure. Presentation layer and application layer and database layer. presentation layer, application layer, and database layer. Now you people concentrate here. In the R by 3, presentation layer, application layer, and database layer. Database layer. Suite 4 in the sense fourth generation application. This is the old application, SAP Business Suite, nothing but SAP R by 3, real time data process. R means real time data process, 3 means 3-tier architecture. This is called presentation layer, application layer, and database layer. Database, up to 2010, we are the tenants of other databases. SAP do not have own database up to 2010. Okay, example. what is meant by presentation layer? Example, presentation layer nothing but where you are giving to the inputs and where you are view the results. That is called presentation layer. Example in the SAP Easy Access Screen. SAP Easy Access Screen is the presentation layer. Why? Because there I am entering to the inputs. There I am visible to the reports. Okay. SAP Easy Access Screen is a presentation layer. So this presentation layer, how it is work? The presentation layer work with the GUI. GUI. What is meant by GUI? Graphical User Interface. This is just for the introduction class. Please concentrate here. How the presentation layer will work? Presentation layer will work with the help of GUI, Graphical User Interface. So what is the main aim of GUI? GUI main aim is, It is the link between presentation layer and application layer. It is the link between presentation layer and application layer. In the R by 3, what is my application layer? My application layer is SAP ERP ECC 6.0 or 6.0, whatever, 6.0 or 6.0. This is my application. SAP ERP ECC 6.0 or 6.0. This is one of the application. And so if you enter any data, for example, I want to post rent account data to cash. Example, 1,000 rupees and 1,000 rupees. This accounting entry I want to post. Where I can post this accounting entry? This accounting entry I can post in presentation layer. And this data will first go to application layer. Then the data finally going to saved in the database layer. Where is that? Here. Everyone, concentrate here. If I post any accounting entry or if I post any document entry, that document entry I can able to post in presentation layer. The information going to presentation layer to application layer and application layer to database layer. The finally, this information going to saved in the database layer as a tables. How the data will save in the database layer? That all the accounting entries, all the entries, all the document entries, whatever you want to post. Okay, all the information saved in the database layer as a tables. Okay, if you post any document in the presentation layer, that information first going to application layer, then that information application layer to database layer. In the database layer, that information saved as a tables, saved as a tables. Okay, for example, I want to generate one report. Example, I want to generate rent report. So where I am able to enter the inputs? In the presentation layer, I can enter the inputs. If you enter the inputs, that inputs going to application layer and database layer. The report will come from the database layer. To presentation layer. If you post any document, that information going to presentation layer to database layer. If you generate any report, that information come from the database layer to presentation layer. So this is one architecture. This is one of the old architecture before 2010. This is called R/3 real time data process. The application is SAP ERP ECC 6.0 or 6.0. Presentation layer, application layer and database layer. The information saved as a tables. Now, later what happened? Everyone, please concentrate here. In the 2010, SAP has introduced SAP Business Suite on HANA. So what happened here? Also R/3 real time data process, three tier architecture. Example, now there is a no change with presentation layer, there is a no change with application layer. The changes is only in the database layer. Example, let's see. Example, there is a no changes in presentation layer and same presentation layer. The first one is called presentation layer and the second one is called application layer. Second layer is application layer and third layer. Everyone, please concentrate here. This is the very, 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 very important. The third layer. In the database layer, SAP has introduced HANA database. The presentation layer, there is a no changes. Application layer, there is a no changes. In the database layer, there is an a changes. It is called migration. The information has been migrated, means database has been migrated. Like you people sometimes heard about that migration projects. Migration project means database moving other database to HANA database, like Oracle database, SQL database. Is there any other databases? migration means we are moving the database, other database to HANA database. Like same thing in the presentation layer, same user GUI, graphical user interface, then application layer SAP ERP ECC 6.0. in the database layer there is an changes, HANA database. It's the own database. Okay, so there is a no changes remaining things. There is a no changes in remaining things. And later what happened? Later what happened? So this is called SAP Business Suite on HANA. And later in the 2014, SAP has introduced, SAP SF powered by SAP HANA. Try to understand this. What is this? SAP SF. What is mean by SF? SF means simple finance. In the 2014, SAP has introduced SF, simple finance. SAP has introduced simple finance. It is add-on application. Everyone, please concentrate here. What is mean by SF? SF means simple finance. It is add-on application. There is a no changes in presentation layer. In the application layer, the SAP is add-on. That add-on application is called simple finance application. Let's see this one. Example. Add-on, that is called add-on application. Simple finance, SF means SAP simple finance powered by SAP, S for HANA, SAP HANA. Okay, let's see here. Once again, SAP SF simple finance powered by SAP HANA. Like there is a presentation layer, there is a no changes. Presentation layer, there is a no changes. Then application layer, example application layer also same. Then database layer, it is a own database now. Now it is a own database, HANA database. And now everyone, please concentrate here. In the 2014, SAP has introduced simple finance. Simple finance means it is add-on application. It is just for the add-on application. Simple finance is a add-on application. It is one of the add-on application. And there is a no changes in presentation layer. Still it is an GUI, graphical user interface. Then there is a no changes in application layer. It is still SAP ERP ECC 6.0. But add-on, there is an add-on, one more application. That application is called Simple Finance. So what is mean by simple finance? What they are simplified here? They are simplified all the tables in this year. They are simplified all the tables. Example, in this application layer, add-on. Then database layer, same. HANA database. Application layer. Now it is SAP ERP ECC 6.0, same application, one more application add-on, simple finance. So what is meant by simple finance? What they are simplified? They are simplified the tables. It is a simplified. Now finally in the 2015 everyone, now in the 2015 SAP has introduced SAP S/4HANA. So what do you mean by that? SAP S/4HANA. Now this is also three-tier architecture. What is that three-tier architecture? Same presentation layer. In the presentation layer, now there is a no GUI. Now presently in the SAP S/4HANA, in the 2015 SAP has introduced UI5. Instead of using GUI, now SAP has introduced in the presentation layer UI5. It is a link between presentation layer and application layer. Now in the 2015 SAP has introduced SAP S/4HANA. Now is Simple Finance become a SAP S/4HANA? This SAP ERP ECC 6.0 become a SAP S/4HANA. So these two applications now become a SAP S/4HANA. This two application now it's become a SAP S/4HANA. Now in the 2015 SAP has introduced SAP S/4HANA. Now it's a own database, HANA database. It's own database, like HANA database. See this one? Take one second. See this one. Now, even this presentation layer also going to changed. GUI to UI5. See, let's see the history. Before 2010, what happened? First R/3, presentation layer, application layer, and database layer. Database layer not is a own database layer. We are tenants of other database layer. What is my application layer? SAP ERP ECC 6.0. What is my presentation layer? Like GUI, presentation layer, application layer, and database layer. In the 2010, presentation layer, application layer, now own database layer, HANA database layer. In the 2015, presentation layer, GUI, here add-on application, Simple Finance. In the 2015, SAP has introduced SAP S/4HANA, like in the presentation layer UI5. Example, what is the version on SAP S/4HANA? Example, the 2015 SAP has introduced 15/11th version. 15 means 2015, 11 means November, 11th month, 15th year. The next year in the 2016, SAP has introduced 16/10th version. In the 2017, SAP has introduced 1709 version. In the 2018, 1809 version. And now we are going to learn 1909 version. It is the latest version, 1909. This is the versions in SAP S/4HANA. This is the versions of SAP S/4HANA. This S/4HANA is a cloud. SAP S/4HANA is a cloud version. Okay. This is the SAP S4HANA is, it's in a cloud version. Again, this cloud is two types of, let's see this one. Everyone, please concentrate here. This, one second. Better calm down. SAP S4HANA is, it is in a cloud. It is in a cloud. This cloud, again, this cloud is becoming two types. One is on-premises and cloud. Again, it is a two types. One is on-premises on-premises and cloud. Cloud. Again, this cloud is two types. Again, this cloud is two types. What is that? Again, this cloud is two types. One is private cloud. Private cloud. And public cloud. Public cloud. Again, two types of clouds in SAP. See this one, SAP S/4HANA is in a cloud. We have two types of clouds, on-premises and cloud. In this cloud, we have private cloud and public cloud. Okay, these are two types. It's in a private cloud. In the SAP S/4HANA, SAP transfer system, application, products for data process. S means suit, 4 means fourth generation. Suit means application. It is fourth generation application. HANA means database. Fourth generation database application. Okay. Now we are able to learn 1909. We are discussing 1909 version. So this is just for the introduction. How SAP is become a ERP to S/4HANA. The coming sessions, we will discuss more. Okay, in case of any doubts, please ping in the comment box. We will revert. Thank you. Thank you very much.